drinking again and thinking of when you loved me. I'm having a few and wishing that you.
So what we're going to do today, the first thing we're going to do is we're going to do a homemade rice. In other words, instead of taking it, you know, from Uncle Ben's or from Rice-A-Roni right out of the box as kind of a side dish, what we're going to do is we're going to just basically make a homemade style rice. So we take about 3/4 cup of a basmati rice in this recipe. Pour that in. About less than 1/4 cup of wild rice. Just place it in there, and then just, you know, maybe an ounce, well not an ounce, but you can see just a little bit of parsley gives it some nice color, and it gives it a nice little bit of flavor, along with about 1/3 cup of the scallion, or the onion. And then the last thing that, Rotisserie does is they put some kind of a seasoning in there. Well, the seasoning that I'm using is just basically a bouillon. This is a chicken bouillon, and I'm doing a chicken tonight, beer belly chicken. So we're going to go ahead and put that in. And so that should be more than enough. We're going to just move it around. We're going to keep it dry until we actually put it on. That's all you do. It's really good. It tastes just as good as the stuff you find in a store. And it's homemade, and probably have a little bit less sodium and a little more flavor. So, you know, we'll see how that tastes. But anyway, that's what we're doing. So we'll set that on here. We'll actually do it grill side, but it's going to sit right there. So that's the first thing we're doing. The second thing we're doing is what's known as a kind of a staple around here, and that is the asparagus spears. So we're going to do some asparagus spears tonight. I've already applied a little bit of olive oil to it, put a little bit more on, and the only other thing you need on there is a little bit of the Greek. Just kind of move it around. Like that, just get it all over, and then these will go directly on the grill. So these will just sit on this plate. We'll take them outside here in just a little while, and we will stick them directly on the grill. Now, the thing about what we're making tonight with the beer belly chicken is this chicken has been actually sitting in 4 beers since yesterday. If it's not intoxicated, it's completely dead, but I'm sure it's completely intoxicated because it's been sitting in these 4 beers, both thawing out and then this morning just kind of chilling out. It really doesn't have much of a, you know, chicken sound any longer. It's more like, it can't even talk. I'd be concerned if it actually could talk. But it's basically what we call beer belly chicken, and it's it's wet right now. And what I'm going to do is with these 4 beers that it's in, I'm just going to dump it out. A turkey. We just shove it up its rear end and try not to make a mess, obviously. There we go. Stick it up its butt or up its rear and put it all the way down. And you want to take those 2 legs right there, as you can see, and you want to make sure that they get put underneath, so that they don't flail around. Stick it all the way in like that. And then we take the other end and we place it on like this. And we want to make sure that skin stays on. And then what we're going to do is we're going to tuck these wings in so they don't go flailing. There we go. You can just stick them right onto the rotisserie rod like that so they don't go anywhere. Seems like a lot of work, but it ends up tasting really good. So this is a dry marinade. This thing is just right now. It's just going to kind of airy out. And it'll be on the grill for about 2 hours. We're going to use hickory. Hickory is really good with chicken. And so we're going to put it on and just let it slow smoke at about 250 to 300 degrees. We'll start it off at 300. Let it get a little bit of brown, and then we'll turn it down, keep it right at 250 for the rest of the day. Only thing we're going to put on this thing right now is a little bit of salt and pepper, and a little bit of Greek seasoning and some garlic. And that is it. That's all you need on this thing, because the juices itself are going to just come out, and that beer batter, or that beer kind of infused taste, since it was underneath four beers for about 24 hours, is going to really give it a nice moist flavor. A petite Syrah, and I probably showed you this one before, but in the sub $10, $10 to $12, depending on where you buy it, price range, the Cancan Petite Syrah is fantastic. There is another Petite Syrah that they make. It's more like a reserve, and it goes for more like $25 to $40, depending on where you buy it. And it's quite a bit better. It's fantastic. But if you're on any kind of budget at all, in your $10 to $12 range, you can't beat this Petite Syrah. It's got a wonderful flavor. It's full-bodied, and it goes really nice with a piece of chicken that's been drinking beer for 2 days. So you'll like this, and I'm going to go ahead and decant this. I'll put it in a decanter tonight. The other day, I think I showed you guys the Venturi, and the Venturi opens it up and kind of gives it a nice flavor. So what you can do is this: just stick the Venturi into the decanter, and you just go like that. And then basically, it'll sit in the decanter, opening up all the flavonoids. We're grill side, and we've got the hickory smoke going, and I've added a few spices to the chicken, to the beer belly chicken. The beer belly chicken has nothing on it except for pepper, a little bit of Greek seasoning. I dusted it with some garlic pepper, some garlic powder, and some salt, just some sea salt. So that's all it's got on it. That's all it's going to need. And then we'll brush it with a finishing glaze towards the end, which will be made up of beer and some barbecue sauce, and probably put a little bit of tequila in with it as well. All right. So that's what we're doing. This bad boy is going, and it is going to taste delicious. Already smells amazing, which is not surprising. And you can kind of see the beer belly on this guy. You can just kind of see it kind of coming out there. And that's the whole concept. It's the beer belly chicken. All right, this chicken is going all out. This is a beer belly chicken, and boy, does he smell good. It's definitely a male subject. Now we've got the smoke has been going really nice here. We've been going for just about an hour. We're gonna probably go about another 45 minutes to an hour. In about half an hour, we'll put on the asparagus spears you see up here, and then towards the end, we'll put on our finishing glaze. Now the finishing glaze is real simple. I use about 8 ounces of barbecue sauce, and I put one shot of tequila in it, and then I put in cherries and some kind of a grape. Like, I'm using a champagne grape, the little bitty ones, so I use about, I don't know, just a little bunch of them, about the size of my fist, and about 5 or 6 cherries, and I pulverize it, make it all real small. And the smell of this is going to be intoxicating. It's going to go really nice, what we've got there. So just take my word. If you're not good at putting these kind of sauces together, use this, and it'll go really good on this. Now, you could do it with no sauce at all, but I like to just put a little bit of a finishing glaze on it just to kind of give it a little bit of that extra pizzazz on the outside. But this thing's going to taste really, really good. And we'll do a delish taste real soon. Almost finished now. We've got some of that finishing glaze on there right now. Got my rice going, and I've got these big old asparagus spears on. And because they're so big, they go directly on the grill. Don't even need to put these guys inside of the foil. So they'll just sit on there for about 10 to 12 minutes as we finish this up and let this thing continue to smoke. And we will be ready to eat. So we'll go ahead and we'll shut this down for a moment. And let's just
open up this bad boy, this beer belly chicken. Try it. Oh, that's coming out juicy. Dig deep into the, make sure it's getting close to being finished. Pull a little piece out. Oh man, that is so moist. Wow. Wow. That is super freaking amazing. So, I'll tell you, you're gonna love that stuff. So, anyway, I'm glad you joined me on this blog. This will be finished momentarily. Oh, and before I finish up, this is the finishing glaze, as I told you. And it's just applied generously here at the end. So we'll go ahead and put a little bit more on. If you don't have a rotisserie, don't do it. Just make it on the grill and just turn it a lot. And marinate often, grill responsibly. Glad you joined me. Thanks for joining me. And we'll talk to you down the line.
Drinking again and thinking of when you loved me. I'm having a few and wishing that you were here. Making the rounds.